In this video, we have a problem that happened when this high power 3-phase motor starts and runs this conveyor belt. And by the end of this video, we will learn how star delta starters work for 3-phase induction motors. So the problem is, when the operator turns on the conveyor system, the lights dim, computers, servers, and the safety systems restart, and it takes around 5 minutes to get back to work. And this conveyor belt system requires a lot of high cost maintenance for gearboxes and couplings. For sure, the problem with the conveyor system, because the problem happens when turning on the system. So let's examine the system. As you see, the 3-phase motors are used in almost every industrial place. Inside a 3-phase induction motor, we have a 3 separated coils, which are used to produce a rotating magnetic field. This rotating magnetic field will cause the rotor which sits inside the coils to spin, and we can then use this to drive bumps, conveyors, and more. On the top or on the side of the motor, we have an electrical terminal box. Inside this electrical terminal box, we have 6 electrical terminals. Each terminal has a letter and a number. We have U1, V1, and W1, and then W2, U2, and V2. We have a phase 1 coil connected to the 2 U terminals. We then have the phase 2 coil connected to the 2 V terminals. Finally, we have the phase 3 coil which is connected to the 2 W terminals. Here is a real-world example of an induction motor's electrical terminal box. Okay, now we need to connect the power supply to the motor, like our problem here. So we bring in the 3-phase power supply and connect this to their terminals. We always connect the supply side to terminals U1, V1, and W1. Now for the motor to run, we need to complete the circuit. The 3 terminals in our problem are connected like this, and this way is called the delta configuration. For this configuration, we connect each 2 opposite terminals from U1 to W2, V1 to U2, and W1 to V2, and this will give us our delta configuration. This is the schematic diagram for delta configuration, and it's very important and will help us in troubleshooting. Now we have in our problem circuit diagram the motor connected in delta with a supply voltage of 380 volts. That means if we use a multimeter to measure the voltage between any 2 phases, we will get a reading of 380 volts. We call this a line-to-line voltage. Now if we measure across the 2 ends of a coil 2 and 3, we again measure the line-to-line voltage of a 380 volts. Now, what about the current? The current in the line is 11 amperes. By the way, this is a clamp meter, particularly Testo 770-3, and it can measure current and the inrush amp in the wire. You can find an approximated number for line current from the datasheet like this, to make it clear for you before testing, and it's called the nominal current. But the current in a phase will be different. It will be 6.35 amps, and we get that from 11 amps divided by the square root of 3, which gives us a 6.35 amps. That's because the phase is connected to the 2 coils. Now, we need to see what's going on when we turn on the motor. And the best way to do this by using a clamp meter that can measure the inrush amps. Let's turn on the system and see. Can you see? Current is over 5 times higher than the nominal current. Nominal current is the current you would expect from normal use of a motor. So the inrush current happens when a large induction motor starts in delta. So the quick large current demand causes voltage drops throughout the building electrical system. This is the reason for dimming lights and restarting computers, servers, and safety systems. And also the electrical panels and the power sources will rapidly increase in temperature, leading to component failure and even electrical fires. So the question of the day, did you hear about this problem? Or you noticed or found this problem before? Tell me now in the comments. Stopping use the induction AC motors for sure is not the solution. So to reduce the starting current, we simply need to reduce the starting voltage. And here comes the star configuration rule, as you see here. In this method, we connect between W2, U2 and V2 on only one side of the motor terminals. And this will give us our star equivalent design. Now if we look at the star configuration, we again have a line to line voltage of 380 volts. And we will see that if we measure between any two phases. But with a star configuration, all our coils meet at the star point, or the neutral point. The best thing in star configuration, that when we measure the voltage across the ends of any coil, for example, V1, V2 coil, we get a lower value of 220 volts. That's because the coil isn't directly connected between two phases, like the delta version was. One end is connected to the phase, but the other end is connected to the shear point or the neutral point, so the voltage is shared and will be smaller. We can see the 220 volt reading by dividing the 380 volt by the square root of 3, which gives us 220 volts. As the voltage is less, the current will be 2. The star configuration will reduce the coil voltage to around 58% compared to the delta configuration. A lower voltage will lead to a lower current. Current in the coil at star configuration will be around 33% of the delta configuration. This will also lead to a reduction in torque. The star configuration torque will also be around 33% compared to delta. The two ways we just saw of configuring the motor in star or delta are fixed methods. To change them, we have to physically cut the power, open the motor terminals, and then remove the star connector and place the delta connector. As you see, this is not a practical way to do the job. To do this, we need to use three contactors. The contactor is basically used as a switch that contains three main contacts, which connect or disconnect the power supply lines running to the load. The first contactor is the main contactor. We will connect its first three terminals with the three-phase power supply, then connect the second three terminals with the rest terminals of the motor's terminal box. The second contactor is the delta contactor, which will be used for our delta circuit. We will connect its first three terminals with three-phase power supply. Then we connect our phase 1 to terminal V2, which is the phase 2 coil. Then we connect our phase 2 to terminal W2, which is the phase 3 coil. And finally, we connect our phase 3 wire to the U2 terminal, which is the phase 1 coil. The third contactor is the star contactor, which will be used for our star circuit. We will connect the three-phase power like this, then connect the top three phases together. Now if we start running the system, the star configuration works first by energizing both the main and the star contactor terminals, letting the power to flow through the circuit. The star configuration will run for a few seconds, then the star contactor will be disconnected. Then the delta contactor will work with the main contactor to start the delta configuration. The interchange between star and delta contactors is controlled by using a timer, either a special timer called star delta timer or an ordinary on delay timer. These two previous methods are used in relay logic control. The timer can be an on delay timer block used inside the program you write in the PLC software. This will automatically change the configuration over after a set amount of time. Okay, that's it for this video. But to continue your learning through real problems, then check out the video on screen now, and I will catch you there in new problem. Cheers!